Congratulations on the unveil, but we've got some news I want to hit first.
Sure.
You've been getting some financing, we understand.
Oh,
you're
yes.
raising money to be able to put out these new glasses at a cheaper price point.
I agree, yes. It's getting heated up for the whole race, right? And, you know, it's getting exciting as well for the whole industry to really see glasses can really be the next computing platform. Paired with AI, you know, I think at some point it can truly replace the cell phone we're using today.
Going back to the financing.
Yeah.
Raised about $100 million.
Yep.
Able to disclose what valuation, who's backing you?
I would say at this moment it's mainly supply chain partners and some key vendors. You know, at this moment there's not more information I can share, but definitely later.
But $100 million is accurate?
Yes.
I think there's a bit of an academic debate to be had here. I've used that phrase a lot, but is glasses the right form factor? The Razer CEO is actually on the program.
Okay.
Talking about how headphones might be the better form factor in an AI world. You know, you have options in the wearables category.
Yep.
Is he right, wrong?
Well, okay, so I just met him actually a couple of days ago.
Okay.
We talked about this
one. Argument?
We talked a little bit about that, but for me, you know, from my perspective, I do think glasses is the ultimate kind of form factor. You know, when we see how we actually evolve going from the big screen to your laptop, to your cell phone, the screen is getting closer and closer. And what is even closer than your cell phone? It's probably going to be this display right in front of your eyes, right? And also, in my opinion, with a pair, you know, combination of AI, you can actually have an AI assistant seeing your eye, see what you see, feel and hear what you hear 24/7. If that is actually available, I do believe, you know, there's no other advantage you can compete with the glasses.
Meta's going to step further right and now put the display in. Worries you? Doesn't worry you?
No. I think, you know, it's a great competition. You know, Meta definitely have a lot of advantages. You know, they have a lot of investment, great talent, and they start really, really early, right? But still, I think this is big enough market. And still, I don't really see the form factor kind of converge. So this is open race for everybody. I'm just excited, you know, to be part of that journey.
Well, the people we're waiting for the unveil from is Google.
Yes.
How are you working alongside Google? How is your relationship deepening? How is Project Aura?
Okay, that's a great question. You know, this week we just, you know, announced that we're deepening the partnership with multi-year extension, and also named Xreal being the lead hardware partner with Google on Android XR. And this is really great, exciting moments. I think maybe it's not just one company going to do everything, you know, together. Maybe it's kind of combination, the hardware and software collaboration at some point. And Xreal, we are really good at building optical modules, building chips, you know, and, you know, Google, they're really good at building AI, building an operating system. So I think, you know, this is a win-win situation for us to team up together to kind of polish the end-to-end hardware and software ecosystem experiences together.
So do you think it'll almost be like a cell phone world in that you have the Google Pixel, but you also have Samsung with the Android operating system and a myriad of others using Android? So is it going to be Google with their own hardware and their own...
Absolutely.
And then, or you're going to be the hardware partner of choice and then be some others out there?
Absolutely.
As well.
If you remember early on, actually, Google partnered with HTC. You know, at the very beginning to define the whole smartphone industry, part of it, you know, alongside with Apple. And then they start to rolling out to LG, to Samsung, and then they have their own Pixels, right? So it's gonna be an ecosystem play. We're just, you know, we just feel lucky. We got picked by Google, so we can work together being the pioneer to drive this industry forward.
When Project Aura glasses come to the real world?
26. It's gonna be this year.
What does the rollout look like?
Well, that's something I cannot share at this moment.
But you will go to market, you'll say they're ready, this is what they look like, this is what they cost, and
yeah,
it'll be available?
Mean, of course, you know, when the time is ready, we'll release those kind of information.
There are some other things that you're battling with your latest generation existing Xreal glasses, right?
Absolutely.
Sleeker, lower price. Price is so important, but you are going up against a market where we have Vision Pro
yep.
and other similar products. And then we question immersion and field of view.
That's right.
What's your response to those
and
questions?
You know, people start to think about, you know, maybe for Apple Vision Pro, it is great experience. But the question and challenge is, you know, it is too expensive. It is too heavy, right? So how can we come up with something, you know, lighter, more affordable, like, but we can deliver like 80% of that kind of experience. And that's where, you know, Xreal Glass is coming about. And especially if you look at the latest generation 1S, right? We further kind of bump up the features. You know, some of the, you know, very unique feature we say is 2D to 3D lifetime conversion. We're using our own chip to do this AI conversion in the real time. And it's amazing, any kind of content coming with the glasses, whether it's a cell phone, handheld gaming devices, your laptop, it can turn into 3D in the real time.
Let's talk about how you've got the price point down.
Yes.
Is it because you're making your own chip? Is it a supply chain navigation, or are you just taking a hit from a profit margin perspective?
No, we just, you know, we spend a lot of effort optimizing this whole supply chain. You know, better yield rate, you know, higher volume, all it's kind of going to help to bring the cost down.
Is it coming from China?
Part of that, yes.
And is that a risk, an issue, given the national security concerns here in the United
States?
That's
a great question. You know, we do have this kind of global supply chain strategy as well. It can be China, it can be in other part of the, it can be even in the US in some day.
Just very, very quickly,
yes.
This CES, you've had a lot of foot traffic.
Yes.
Just reflect on that really quick.
Well, you know, people like glasses. And they like to experience. Actually, even though we've been talking about glasses for so long, there's still a lot of people that haven't really tried on any glasses. So I think this is still a long kind of education process.